Hi guys, it's Marco Magliolino from Tomorrow.it. Just a moment that I switch on the keynote. Okay guys, I check the audio. Okay, it's fine. Okay, this night we will do another live webinar. This time I want to change the topic. Last time we have talked about a very technical subject, about prosthetic dentistry, about vertical preparations. Now I want to do something very different, something that you never see usually in courses and congresses. I see that, okay, let's see this nice feature of OBS. It's something that I've learned today, to see the comments and the chat here on the left of the screen. Honestly, this night we will talk about something that you will never see in other kind of courses, because we dentists, all the medical field, we are not so much acquainted with failure. Most of cases, doctors tend to hide their failures. We have little ability to share failure. But the reality, and it is what I will show in this lecture, is that, honestly, failure has been my very first reason to improve in my life. In the past, honestly, I was shy. I was hiding my failures. When some people was coming to my office in the past, I was checking for the planning in order that I had perfect patient and perfect cases. Now, I don't do. So I think that we have to change our approach to failure. What I do this night is to show mine. But it is because I want you to change your approach with failures. So let's start with this lecture. I hope that you will learn something about dentistry, but honestly, I hope that I will be able to give you a small push, a small hint to change your mindset about when things go wrong. Also because, you know, in Italy and most of the Europe, the situation is quite not so nice, we can say. So this is another period of our life where we have to deal with something that is not so much nice. So let's start with this keynote. We can say life. What is life? At the end, life is so many things and something so philosophical that we have not an answer. But at the end, life is what we do. And it's very nice to understand in our life how do we spend our time. Because it's calculated that we men, not you women, of course, we men spend 3,000 hours shaving. And if you are rich, like Daniele Bordonati, you go to the barber. We spend 6 years, and I am afraid that in the next future, it will be much more. We spend 6 years staying on our phone, okay? Chatting, Messenger, Facebook, what are you doing now? I never do this, but usually we spend 11 years watching TV, and usually it's trash. Honestly, we spend 28,000 hours eating. We spend 26 years sleeping. But honestly, in our life, the most important time that we spend in our life, it's 100,000. It's working. So honestly, it's just because I want to say that work is important, but it's because working is a so big part of our life that the quality of life that you have in your work, it's the quality of the life that you have. I always strived for excellence, honestly. I've tried, of course, with some ups and some downs, but it's the approach to go for excellence that changes your life in every field. Wait for a moment. I go back Okay, here. This was a famous Vince Lombardi. He was a famous trainer of football. Okay, nothing so important. But Vince was an amazing motivator for people, for their athletes, for their players. He said that the quality of our life is related to our commitment to excellence in our field of work. It doesn't matter the field. So, even if, according to our patient, in many cases, we are not so nice doctors, okay? And we are much more similar in the mind of our patient to Montgomery Burns, an ugly doctor just looking for some money. I really love what I do, and I really think that the way in which I do my work will change my life. When we talk about excellence, there is always one question. The path toward excellence is a matter of talent, of genius. Because I see, talking with colleagues, when I go to courses and congresses, that many, many persons always talk about this so-called talent, okay? About this so-called genius. I read a lot of books about this topic, honestly, and this is one of the books I prefer. This is the books from Albert Erickson, Anders Erickson, I have here. This is the Italian version for the Italian readers because the title is different. It's Numero Uno Si Diventa. Instead, in English, is completely different. The title is Secrets from the New Science of Expertise. But this book is very interesting because according to the authors, because they studied the cognitive biases in all the fields to understand how human psychology works, and they discovered that doctors exercising from 20 or 30 years were worse than doctors just specialized. They found that the mere repetition of a task every day is not related to improving or maintenance of this ability. You have to go with this concept. The simple repetition of a task every day make the doctor getting worse during the years. So most of the senior doctors work in a worse way than the younger ones. So the reality is that in the life and in the work, or you go ahead or you go back. You cannot stop at your level of your abilities. There is no a balance in the life. You have to strive to go on, to go forward, or otherwise the law of gravity, you will go back. And the simple time, it's not about 12 hours working, it's not enough. Experience means nothing and practice alone is useless. So we go to the focus of today. Why? Because to improve ourselves, it's not enough to work, but you have to do what they call focused practice. And it is a sequence of small objectives in order to go to arrive to the bigger one. And focused practice need feedback. Okay? And need to go over your area of confidence. Just a bit, but you have continuously to go over your skill. The problem is the feedback is what I see, is the very critical point. Because adding a feedback means accept and recognizing a mistake. And we as a doctors have a culture prone not to look at mistakes. We talk always about complications with patients, especially when we talk about more important things in the hospital. We always talk about accident, but we never talk about mistakes because we are scared about them. We are scared about how other people, how other doctors will look at our service. We are scared about how we look at our service, like people with a lack of experience, a lack of ability. Another problem, we need the sequence to arrive to a goal. But which is the goal? Because it's easy to say that in our profession, the aim is the clinical success. But what are the objectives that we have to follow to arrive to the clinical success? And this is another problem. Because when I was young, I did a lot of courses following and dreaming about the so-called state of art of dentistry, about adhesive dentistry, modern dentistry, rubber dam everywhere, even on my head, thinking that this was the path to successful dentistry. But as you see, for example, in this case, this beautiful shoulder on this horizontal prep with this beautiful fiber post, look the outcome, the clinical outcome that we have, and we will see this case in details. Excuse me for this, but my barber is closed in these days, so. The problem is that nowadays, guys, if you want to send me messages, send on the, not in the private one, because I cannot answer, because I'm using the iPhone like a cam, okay? Send here on the chat, because I have the possibility to look at the comments in the chat. Okay. Unfortunately, nowadays we live in a period where we like to show our best. Angelina Jolie and Brad Pitt. Here, this is an Italian magazine. Happy to love. We like to show these images of happiness. And this is instead the clinical outcome, we can say. Divorce for irreconcilable differences. We show just a part of our life. And in a field like dentistry, like medicine, this is really a problem. Because without recognizing our mistakes, we will never be able to go on. This is a part of a bigger lecture that I have, honestly. But I think that even with this short one, and this is not so short, however, I will drive you to the point. Because when we go to the Congress, we always see these cases, patient with this kind of smile, aesthetic request. This was the preoperative with the milky canine, some discectomy on these central incisors, aesthetic problem, there was a bascule of the occlusal plane. And this is the follow-up after 4 years, after some radium disilicate crowns and veneers and bulbo gingival surgery. And this is the smile of the patient after 4 years and off. We love these cases. Another case, for example, this patient complaining about the complete lack of his teeth during smile, problem of abrasion, erosion. I did this case with a complete adhesive approach, just using only veneers, you know. This is the veneers made by my technician, Moreno Tarascio. Here, the miracle and the dream of adhesive dentistry, even on posterior area, from